Welcome to HSPF Training by DSI. This is Anurag Mishra. We are at the video HSPF 170. How do I output HSPF model simulation results in a WDM format? In the last video, we output the HSPF model simulation results in HSPF binary and text format. However, the issue with HSPF binary and the text format is that it does not give you a fine control. So for example, in the last video, what we did that we said eye water for impervious land one is being output. However, eye water for a simple model like this can have 6 time series. Or for a complex model, there could be more time series. You don't get to pick and choose whether you want surface runoff only or potential evapotranspiration or actual evapotranspiration. That for that kind of fine control, and it's the same thing with the dot out output also. So if you want a fine control, you want to a very specific time series from a very specific operation. We use EXE targets block. So let's go to the EXE targets block. So I just added a blank EXE targets block. There is no information in here right now. So what I do here is I tell, okay, which operation I want, implant, operation number one. The group is eye water. That is where the water-related operations are taking place. Sero is the time series from that operation. If you remember in the last video, we looked at in the group eye water, what are the time series? Sero is one of the time series, and the units are inches per time step. And as you can see here, the subscripts are 1 and 1. These subscripts will stay 1 and 1 for most of the constituents. Once you start going into water quality or sediment, these subscripts will change, and we'll explore more about it then. So I don't want any multiplication factor. I don't want to multiply it with anything. Sometimes you may want to do some kind of unit change or conversion. Translation string is that if you want to get an average time series, for example, daily average, daily maximum, in volume name, which WDM file do I want to get the output in? We are reading the meteorological data from the file WDM1. I can choose same WDM file here. When the models become complex, we sometimes want to keep these two WDM files separate. For now, we are going to keep it same. And what is the number of the time series that we are going to output it? Let's call it 9,000. And member name, whatever name we want to see it in a WDM file, let's call it Sero, same as this one. Or let's call it iSero because it is impervious surface runoff. Quality flag 1. This doesn't matter here. And I don't remember these aggregation is. Aggregation is that if you want to aggregate it from hourly to daily, and this string is REPL, replace, that means we are going to change the data. We are going to remove the data from the existing data set in the WDM file and replace it with this one. And let's see if it works. So if the WDM file does not have this data set, this WDM1 file, this will create that data set. So this is the output units. So if I want to see the output in English or if I want to see the output in metric. So let's say I want to see the output in metric. So now what I did was that I said for impervious land operation number one, I want to see the surface runoff in this data set in this WDM file. That's it. Right now, my WDM file does not have any data set with this number, so it's going to create a new one. So let's run WinHSPF. So it looks like the run finished. If you want to see the run finished properly, you can always click look at the echo file, control end, end of job. And then we are going to look at the WDM file. And what is the name of the WDM file? Control home, HSPF underscore test. Here is the WDM file. It has three time series. Let's look at the time series. So what we'll do is we'll add an attribute. Let's the ID attribute. Remember that every time series has a unique ID or DSN. So 9000 was the one that we were outputting. Let's click on that. So that was the impervious land one. ISERO was the name that we gave. We can click on that, and the time series is here. We can list it. Now, getting an output from a WDM in a WDM file gives a very fine control. And when you are outputting, when you're working on a model that is very big, has multiple operations and multiple modules, then you may not want to output everything that the model is calculating, and so you may want to get those output. Additionally, you can also use the WDM toolbox library by Tim Serra, and you can actually read the WDM dataset right away as soon as the model run is finished, and you can process it for any graphs or preparing it for any other downstream model. So this, the past video and this video showed us how to get some of the outputs in different formats: print output, that is text, binary, and WDM file. I hope this gives you a good overview of how a UCI file and HSPF work. In the next videos, we will look at some of the common errors that you will encounter when you are using a HSPF model. Thank you.